Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, that is Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and today's topic for Biochemistry Rapid Revision Series is Glycogen Storage Diseases. We will also see some tricks and mnemonic to remember glycogen storage diseases. Glycogen storage diseases are a group of inherited disorders characterized by the deposition of abnormal glycogen or quantity of glycogen in the tissues or inability to mobilize the glycogen. Now, what are the various types of glycogen storage diseases? So, the first one is the type 0, which is known as the liver glycogen synthase deficiency. And as the name suggests, there is a deficiency of glycogen synthase enzyme. Now, what are the biochemical features of liver glycogen synthase deficiency? So, this one is the unique among all the diseases of glycogen metabolism because it is characterized by the deficiency of glycogen rather than its accumulation. And there will be the episodes of transient hyperglycemia after the meals and hypoglycemia in between the meals. Second glycogen storage diseases is the type 1 glycogen storage diseases, which is known as the Van Gucht's disease. And it is occurred due to the deficiency of glucose 6 phosphatase enzyme. As there is a deficiency of glucose 6 phosphatase enzyme, so there will be no conversion of glucose 6 phosphate into the free glucose in the liver. So there will be the fasting hypoglycemia, lactic acidosis, there will be the accumulation of glycogen in the liver, so there will it will lead to the hepatomegaly. And as glucose 6 phosphate will be not converted to the free glucose, so this glucose 6 phosphate will be channeled towards HMB shunt pathway, which will result in the increased synthesis of pentose sugar. Ultimately, it will lead to the increased breakdown of pentose sugar and ultimately increased level of uric acid in the blood. So that are the characteristic finding of Van Gucht disease. Remember, in the Van Gucht disease, there will be the accumulation of normal glycogen. Then type 2 glycogen storage diseases, which is known as the Pompe's disease. And Pompe's disease occurs due to the deficiency of acid maltase enzyme in the lysosome. So it is characterized by the accumulation of glycogen in the lysosome of all the tissues. Again, over here, there will be the accumulation of normal glycogen. Then type 3. Type 3 is known as the Cori's disease, Fob's disease or limit dextrinosis. And it is characterized by the deficiency of debranching enzyme. Fine. Now, what are the biochemical features of Cori's disease? So, as there is a deficiency of debranching enzyme, so the glycogen degradation will be incomplete because the outer branches of the glycogen molecule will be removed by a phosphorylase enzyme, but the inner core of the molecule will remain intact. So this abnormal form of glycogen will be accumulated in the liver. It will be characterized by the hepatomegaly. Another features of this Cori's disease are similar to that of Van Gucht's disease, but it will occur in the milder form. And in the Cori's disease, as discussed, there will be the accumulation of abnormal glycogen. Then type 4 glycogen storage diseases, which is known as the Anderson's disease, and it occurs due to the deficiency of branching enzyme. Again, as there is a deficiency of branching enzyme, so there will be the accumulation of abnormal form of glycogen in the liver, which is characterized by the long unbranched chain. And this one is the very severe glycogen storage diseases. Fine. Early death occurs due to the cardiac or liver failure before the age of 5. So that is the type 4 Anderson's disease. And you can remember this type 3 and type 4 glycogen storage diseases by one mnemonic, that is ABCD. So A stands for Anderson's disease and B stands for branching enzyme. So this Anderson's disease occurs due to the deficiency of branching enzyme. Then C and D. So CD. So C stands for Cori's disease and D stands for debranching enzyme. Okay. Then type 5 glycogen storage diseases. So type 5 glycogen storage diseases is the McAdult's disease, and it occurs due to the deficiency of muscle glycogen phosphorylase. As there is a deficiency of glycogen phosphorylase enzyme in the muscle, so muscle glycogenolysis will be defective. So there will be no release of glucose from the glycogen which is stored in the muscle. So there will be the exercise intolerance, person will not be able to tolerate strenuous activity, and muscle cramps will occur on the mild exertion. So that is the type 5. Type 6 glycogen storage diseases is the Hurst disease, which occurs due to the deficiency of liver glycogen phosphorylase enzyme. So there will be the hepatic glycogenolysis will be impaired. So it will be characterized by the hepatomegaly as well as mild hypoglycemia. And remember, in the type 5 and type 6, there will be the accumulation of normal glycogen. In the type 3 and 4, there will be the accumulation of abnormal glycogen. Then type 7. Type 7 is the Tourette's disease, which occurs due to the deficiency of phosphofructokinase in the muscle and in the RBC. And it is characterized by the hemolytic anemia as well as exercise intolerance, same as that of type 5 glycogen storage diseases. So that is all about glycogen storage diseases. Now we will see one mnemonic to remember the names of glycogen storage diseases. So the mnemonic is Wo Physics, Chemistry or Maths Mein Hoshiar Tha. So Wo stands for Van Gogh's disease, Physics so stands for Pompe's disease, Chemistry so Cori's disease, or that is Anderson's disease, Maths Mein that is McArdle, Hoshiar that's Hurst disease, and Tha means Tourette's disease. So that is Wo Physics, Chemistry or Maths Mein Hoshiar Tha. So that is all about glycogen storage diseases. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.